The last time I spoke to one brother who was smoking like a chimney, and believe me, everyone agrees smoking is a bad habit. Brother, quit it! He says, who are you? I said, the Quran says, do not use your own hands to destroy your own selves, and do not kill yourselves, for indeed Allah is most merciful upon you. So this is a way of harming yourself. Do you know what answer he gave me? He said, well, you stop breathing. I told him, what do you mean? He says, if you breathe oxygen, 70 years later you die. It took me a second to figure that out, but I was shocked. I said, what a statement. So he's saying oxygen also contaminates your system. Stop breathing. Imagine the answer. I said, my beloved brother, we are saying it out of love. I know today we have so many people who might be smoking, but I'm still saying it with that amount of love to say, my brother, I have bad habits. May Allah make me quit them. But that doesn't mean we mustn't raise the other bad habits. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help you to quit it. Wallahi, look at the Sahaba radiallahu anhum. As soon as Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam uttered the statement, they immediately surrendered to it. I want to give you one example. There was a messenger who came in Medina Munawwara. He says, behold, this intoxicating drink has been made prohibited. What did they say? They spat it out of their mouths in some instances. They threw down whatever they had. The drums that were filled with the alcohol. That is why they were Sahaba radiallahu anhum. They dropped it, they blocked it, they stopped it, they threw it away, and they said, never again. Alhamdulillah, 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 all thanks.